Ladies and gentlemen. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we're anticipating a full house. We'll be starting here momentarily, but I just wanted to give you a little bit of a logistical information. And just the logistics, at the end of the presentation, we will be allowing you guys to pick up your kids back at the band hall. But as you realize, real quick, through the high school, it's a one-door process. So what we're asking everyone to do is when the program is completed, we're asking everyone to exit towards the parking lot. We will have two doors open cutting across the courtyard to hook back to get your kiddos out of the band hall. So again, we're asking everyone to exit towards the parking lot. And then if you are picking up a child, go back through the courtyard and hook around to get them. If you decide to leave your child with us, we will charge you extra later on to pick them up. But for now, you can have them back for free. We'll get started momentarily. Thank you all for coming out with us.
I have one more announcement before we get started here in a couple of minutes. We are going to invite our veterans up here and our those serving in our armed forces, if you would like to be recognized. After we do our Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem, if you would like to come up onto the stage, walk across, and exit on that side. And we have some of our students that have made some little gifts for you. And so we'll have our couple of fifth graders over here distributing those to you, and then you can make your way back to your seats so that we can start our show. If we have anybody who has a wheelchair, if you're not comfortable coming up on the stairs, you are welcome to come straight across in front of the stage if you want to participate in that. Thank you. We'll get ready to start in just a few minutes.
Thank you. Oh, gotcha. Miss Ricks, let's move them forward one second.
I'm actually.
Oh.
It's their program, so.
Yes.
The Maury? Good evening. I am Mrs. Ripps, music teacher at Lytle Elementary, and I'd like to welcome you to our Veterans Day show this evening, and I wanted to introduce our readers for this evening. They are Velia Perez, Katie Martinez, and Marissa Lopez. And with that, we will begin.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Lytle Elementary's 2015 Veterans Day celebration. We will have the Cub Scouts from Pack 369 present the colors.
Color guard attention.
Color guard at attention.
Color guard advance.
Color guard advance.
Color guard halt.
Right place.
Will everyone join me for the Pledge of Allegiance?
Will everybody join him in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing with your hand over your heart as our national anthem is played.
like our post colors. Return to post.
Color guard, return to post.
Thank you. Audience, you may be seated. Veterans, our students would like to present you with a small token of our thanks and appreciation for your bravery and sacrifice and all that you have done to preserve our freedom. We thank you. Audience, would you please help me welcome our honored guests, our veterans, as they come up and walk across our stage. If you would, please enter the stage here near the podium and walk across to receive a token of our thanks. Thank you.
Caissons go rolling along. For it's high, high need in the field artillery. Count out your numbers loud and strong. 2, 3, 4, hut, 2, 3. And wherever you go, you will always know that those caissons go rolling along. Oh.
When the call went out for volunteers and a nation being born, no sunshine patriot speeches, no summer soldier song. For the special ones who paid the price to keep the country strong.
When we were needed, we were there. We were there when we were needed, we were there.
No, it wasn't always easy. It wasn't always fair. But when freedom called, we answered, we were there. Wanna find out who we are, just ask us where we've been. From the frozen fields of Valley Forge to a trail called Ho Chi Minh. Through the glory and the sacrifice, we do our job each day. We're citizens and soldiers, an army all the way.
When we were needed, we were there. We were there when we were needed.
Welcome now our guest speaker, Mr. Daniel Toole, veteran and second grade teacher at Lido Elementary School.
Today, there is, and perhaps always will be, conflict in the world. But the United States, fortunately, enjoys peace and freedom. Like other great things of value, this security did not come cheaply. Part of that cost has already been paid by Americans who answered the call to military duty when their country needed them. They served 11 wars, from the Revolution to the Persian Gulf, earning the special distinction, veteran. But another part of freedom's cost must continue to be paid long after the guns have been silenced. This debt is owed Americans' veterans. Some need their country's help, even as their country once needed theirs, to readjust, to recover from wounds, or to overcome hardships of age and infirmity. Most ask nothing in repayment for their sacrifices. Let us continue to help those veterans in need with the greatest possible compassion and efficiency. To rest, since they ask no special help, we can best pay tribute this day by recognizing what they have achieved and joining them in the resolve to keep America strong and free.
Thank you, Mr. Toole. Our first performance of the evening is by our fifth grade students.
Thank you, fifth graders. Our second performance will be by Mr. Tools and Mrs. Davenport's classes. They're excited to let you know how much we appreciate our veterans.
Once we have war, there's only one thing to do, for defeat brings worse than any that can ever happen in war. Ernest Miller Hemingway. A hero is someone who has given his or her life to something bigger than oneself.
Thank you.
As we express our gratitude, we must never forget that our highest appreciation is not to utter words, but to live by them. John F. Kennedy.
This nation will remain the land of the free only so long as it is the home of the brave.
Next are Mrs. Hundley's and Ms. Boone's classes. They will be performing a special tribute to veteran Mr. Ralph Taylor, who recently passed away on September 28, 2015. He served in the Air Force for 27 years and was a senior master sergeant. He retired as a training superintendent. Mr. Taylor worked tirelessly in our community to teach us all about respecting our American flag, what it meant, and how important it is that we should all take pride in flying this important symbol of our freedom. Mr. Taylor dedicated many early morning hours to come to our school to instruct our fifth grade student patrols on proper flag etiquette and respect. He instilled in them a love and enthusiasm for all that our flag stands for. It is with that same enthusiasm now that we dedicate this next performance to Mr. Ralph Taylor. Here is your grand old flag. Thank you. Ms. DeBoard's and Mr. Gomez classes, third grade classes, are here to sing about living in the heart of America.
Yeah.
The lyrics to this next song were written by Catherine Lee Bates, and the music was composed by Samuel A. Ward. Ms. Bates originally wrote the words as a poem called Pike's Peak, after a train trip she had taken to Colorado Springs, Colorado. While she was on Pike's Peak, the words of the poem started to come to her. The poem was inspired by the many sights she saw along the way. Mrs. Salazar's and Mrs. Tomlinson's classes will perform "To America the Beautiful."
Thank you.
Here are some fun facts about our next song, God Bless America. Irving Berlin, who also wrote White Christmas, wrote this in 1918 for the musical Yip, Yip, Yip Hank. After writing it, Berlin felt it didn't fit the tone of the musical, which was a comedy, and decided not to use it. In 1938, with war looming in Europe, Berlin updated the lyrics for the purpose of writing a peace song rather than a war song. Another fun fact, singer Kate Smith introduced this on her radio show on Armistice Day in 1938, November 11th. It was an immediate hit. Berlin donated the royalties from this song, which were considerable, to the Boy and Girl Scouts of America. He established the God Bless America Fund for this purpose. And the last fun fact, Berlin was not born in America. His family immigrated from Siberia when he was 5. Interesting fact. Here are Mrs. Lopez and Mr. Decock's classes performing sign language to Celine Dion's version of God Bless America.
Thank you.
Next are Mr. Boylan and Ms. Lugo's fourth grade classes singing You Are Our Heroes. Here are Mrs. Littleton's and Mrs. Pritchard's classes to sing American Tears.
Sometimes I do have a solo in just a minute.
Okay. In honor of our military veterans and heroes, we would like to present you with a short skit about a military tradition that we learned about in a book, America's White Table, by Margaret Raven. This tradition began after the Vietnam War. It is a remembrance table. This empty table is set to honor the men and women of all branches of the military who cannot join us for meals. This remembrance table reminds us to remember those men and women who served us in our military. This small table represents a soldier in a lonely battle against many.
This white tablecloth on the table honors the soldier's pure heart when he or she answers our country's call of duty.
This black napkin represents the sorrow of being captured.
This empty chair reminds us to think of the ones who are not here.
An upside down glass symbolizes the meal that will not be eaten.
The slice of lemon and the grains of salt make us think of the bitter fate of our soldiers and their families' tears.
The vase with the red rose tied with a red ribbon stands for all hope that all soldiers will return home.
The white candle is a symbol of peace.
You are not forgotten, so long as there is one left in whom your memory remains.
Getting ready for our finale, so if you'll bear with us for a few minutes, get lined up.
All the campaigns was rough, but the worst one that I think that I participated in, and I'm pretty sure most everybody else would agree, was the Battle of the Bulge.
There's an old man in a uniform at the local Walmart store, selling $3 raffle tickets for a picture on the floor. And as he called me over, I asked him what's it for. He said the local 133 were veterans of foreign war. But in his mind he wondered if I knew everything that he had to go through. Will you remember all that I've done? Will you
So I
asked him what the ribbon was there on his chest. He said, back in fight the battle of the bulge. And as I looked at his hands, I could see. Back in 45, he was fighting for me. So I asked him how it happened. Back in 45, he just smiled and looked away. Said every day I thank God I'm alive. But if you know the story, you can say nuts to them who stand in your way. United States, to a country that was thankful for the sacrifices made. And as he sees old glory wave in the sun, he said, thank God, my son, for the freedoms we've won. Now and those that are gone.
Boys and girls, if you would stay on the stage. Thank you, everyone, for coming this evening. We hope you've enjoyed our presentation of thanks and gratitude. We thank all of you who have served and are currently serving in our armed forces for all you've done and for all you do to make this country the great country that it is. We are the home of the free because of you, the brave. Thank you and good night. Parents, you must sign out your child from the band hall with your teachers. They are not allowed to be dismissed from the stage. So if you would please make your way to the band hall through the hallway, and you may be signing out your kids with your teacher there. Thank you.